हेलो स्टूडेंट्स एंड वेलकम बैक वंस अगेन टू दी ऑनलाइन लेक्चर्स ऑफ डिज़ाइन ऑफ आरसीसी एंड स्टील स्ट्रक्चरल एलिमेंट्स. सो इन द लास्ट सेक्शन वी हैव स्टार्टेड विथ सॉल्यूशन ऑफ डिज़ाइन ऑफ कंबाइंड फुटिंग डिज़ाइन ऑफ आरसीसी कंबाइंड फुटिंग फॉर कॉलम ए एंड कॉलम बी. वी डिस्कस अबाउट how to calculate area of the footing, and the important thing is the reason behind to adjust the cg of load or the cg of footing to get uniform pressure below the combined footing. So I told you what is the importance and how to adjust the cg of load so that it will coincide with cg of footing. Then we calculated the offset a, offset b with respect to column a and column b. Okay, so we got that the offset b is more for column b because load acting over column b is more. Okay, and also we checked for the higher upward pressure. We checked for upward pressure also, that is net upward pressure. Q is equal to 1.5 into 1200, that is total load divided by area provided. So we got 180 kN per meter square. And as I told you, the very important point is the upward pressure should be less than factored SBC. It should be less than the SBC, that is safe bearing capacity of soil. And we got it is okay. So it is, we got it is safe. Okay, so next we have to go for the further calculation, because once you got that the footing is safe for factored upward pressure, so we have to go for further calculation. Okay, now we have to go for calculation of bending moment and shear force, because ultimately we have to check the design for calculation of bending moment, and we have to design the footing for bending moment and shear force. Even you have to check for both. Okay, it should be safe for bending and it should be safe for shear. Okay, so further we go for design of, that is the calculation of bending moment and shear force. Okay, so we'll move it with, so I'll just, okay, so here it is design of, sorry, the calculation of shear force and bending moment. That is alright, bending moment. So from this you have to get shear force diagram and bending moment diagram. Okay, so as you know that the pressure here, the net upward pressure Q, you got it as 180 kN per meter square. The net upward pressure is 180 kN per meter square. Understood? So it is nothing but the upward load. It is nothing but the load acting below the footing. It is a load acting below the footing. So we can have the loading diagram for the calculation of shear force and bending moment. We should have the loading diagram for the calculation of shear force and bending moment. Okay, so I'll just draw the loading diagram here. You see, okay, so we'll draw the loading diagram. Okay, so here I'll draw the single line diagram. We have column A and column B. So this is A and B, column A and column B, and below that will be loading diagram. So the upward pressure, so this is upward pressure, so this is nothing but Q. क्यू इज इन किलो न्यूटन पर मीटर स्क्वायर. ओके क्यू किलो न्यूटन पर मीटर स्क्वायर. देन आफ्टर दैट ओके वी हैव द लोड ओवर कॉलम ए इज द फैक्टर लोड इज 750 एंड हियर इट इज 1050. The load acting at A is 750 and load acting over B is 1050 kN. Even we have the distance that offset from here to here and from here to here, that is from with respect to column A and column B. So from column A we have got it as this offset as 0.52 and this offset as 1.08. Both offset we have calculated. Okay. So now as you know that this pressure is kilonewton per meter square, that is 180 kilonewton per meter square, and that pressure we need to convert in terms of kilonewton per meter. We have to convert as a UDL for width of footing. UDL, I will repeat once again, UDL for the width of footing. Okay, so I will draw the rough sketch here again. Okay, so we have the, I will draw the small rough sketch here. Here we have, let us assume this is combined footing, okay. And below there is a pressure here, below this there is a pressure we have 180 kilonewton per meter square. Below this combined footing we have a pressure of 180 kilonewton per meter square. So we have to consider the per meter strip, the per meter length strip. This will be per meter, okay. This is 1 meter. Okay, and this will be, we have assumed as the width of the footing as 2 meter. Then what should be the load below this? So here it is 180, it is in kilonewton per meter square, so I will divide it by 2 to make it in per to have not 2 into 2 we have to multiply, sorry, here we have to multiply into 2, that is width. Here we have to multiply 180 into 2, that is width. Okay, 180 into 2, that is the width of the footing. Okay, so it will be about how much? 360 kilonewton per meter. Means what? 360 kilonewton per meter strip, that is per meter. So this is a strip of 1 meter, then again it will act for per meter like that throughout the length of footing. Okay, so that is 180, you have to multiply into width, the width of the footing, because it is, see, this is very important, okay, because it is kilonewton per meter square into, if you multiply the width B, so this will, the width B, so this will become as kilonewton per meter, so same what you got here. So we got the load, the UDL below the footing acting as UDL, that is the pressure acting as a UDL, that is 360 kilonewton per meter, means this Q we got it as 360 kilonewton per meter. The upward load Q we got it as 360 kilonewton per meter. Earlier it was Q was 360 kilonewton, 180 kilonewton per meter square. The Q was 180 kilonewton per meter square. So when you multiply B, so this B is again in meter, so this meter and this meter goes out, so we got kilonewton per meter, so that is 360 kilonewton per meter. So what you have to do here, you multiply width of the footing over, you multiply width of the footing, so means what, for throughout the width the load acting below the footing is 360 kilonewton per meter. Means what does it mean? I'll just show you. What does it mean? Your footing, so this is the width of footing, your footing will bend like this. Are you getting my point? Your footing will bend like this, so it will bend like this. So this is the width of the footing. If this is the width of footing, this should be length. So your footing will bend like this for per kilonewton per bending, kilonewton per meter bending. Understood? So the load acting below this, the load acting below the footing is how much? 360 kilonewton per meter. The load acting below the footing is how much? 360 kilonewton per meter. Means your footing will bend like this per meter. It will not bend. So we assume per meter. Okay, per meter strip. Understood? So therefore, we can now go for the calculation of bending moment. Okay. So now here. Okay. So now. So therefore. Shear force SF. Okay. So now, so this is shear force. So I'll just name it as, this will be ABCD. I'll name it as just ABCD. Okay. This is A, B, C and D. Limit as A, B, C, D. Okay. Therefore, now shear force at C. Therefore, already shear force SF. So, therefore, shear force at C is equal to 0 kilonewton. So, shear force at C is, it is 0 kilonewton. Then next is shear force at A. Shear force at A, that is left. Shear force at A, that is left of A. So that is, because it is, load is 360 into the upward distance is 0.52. Okay, 360 into 0.52. So I'll just check 360 into 0.52. So you'll get it as 187.2 kilonewton. Okay. Then shear force at A, right. Shear force at A, that is right. Okay. That is again 360 into 0.52. So I'll directly write it as 187.2, that is positive, minus load acting down, that is 750. So we'll get it as minus 0.562.8 kilonewton. So I'll just show it here in the diagram. Okay. Now it is at A. Okay. So here it is. Shear force at C is 0. Shear force at A, that is left of A. Okay. So that is 360 into 0.52. The distance is, the load is 360. The upward load is 360 kilonewton per meter into 0.52. When you go right of A, so that is again 360 into 0.52 minus 750. So this is upward, this is downward. 360 into 0.52 minus 750. So we got these values are, we got these values, that is at A left we got 187.2. At A right we got minus 0.562.8 kilonewton, that is right. Okay. So then shear force at B, so that is again in right, sorry, left. So this we'll take it directly, so minus 562.8 plus 360 into 3.4. So the center to center distance between the two column is 3.4 kilometers. So we get it as 661.20 kilonewton, that is at left. Okay. Now we'll go for shear force at B right again. Okay. Shear force at B right. Okay. So we'll take same value here, 661.20. Minus the load acting, the factor load is 1050. So we'll get it as this value, we'll get it as minus 388.80 kilonewton. So we'll just check that. That is 661.20 minus 1050. Yes, we'll get it as 388.80 kilonewton. Then we'll go for again shear force at D should be equal to 0. Shear force at D. So if you want to check, you can check. So that is minus 388.8 plus 360 into 1.08. Okay, I'll just explain here now. Now we'll, if you check for shear force at B, what will happen? So the forces at left of B and at right of B you have to take. So you have got already the shear force at left of A, we have got it as 661 point. At left of B, we got it as 661.2. Okay. Then when you take shear force at B, when you take shear force at B, so what will happen? So it is at shear force at B is, okay, so that is, we already know that the shear force at left of B is 661, so we can use the same value, 661.60. okay, and when you go directly here it is minus 1050, so this we got it as minus 562 plus 360 into 3.4. Okay, this value, that is 360 into 3.4, because the center to center distance between A and B is 360 into 3.4. So that is 3.4 meter is the center to center distance between A and B. Okay, then so same again at right of B, what you have to do, you have to take again 1050, which is the downward load acting through column B. After that, when you check, go for check at shear force at D, because it is a free end, so the shear force at D again should be equal to 0. So you can directly write, or if you want to check, so again we got it is at minus 388.8 from the previous, that is at shear force at B, right? Then again plus 360 into 1.08, so this is 360 into 1.08, so we got it as 0. Okay, understood. So now we'll go for bending moment, calculation of bending moment. Okay, so shear force we did, now we'll go for bending moment. Okay, so next bending moment, I'll write it as bending moment. Okay, so first of all, bending moment at C is equal to 0 kilonewton meter. Okay, bending moment C is at 0 kilonewton meter. Then bending moment at A with respect to all clockwise movement considering positive, so that is load is 360 into 0.52 into 0.52 divided by 2, that is WL square by 2, UDL, okay, WL square by 2, so that is we will get it as 48.67 kilonewton meter. So we will get it as 48, so that is we will check it here, 360 into 0.52 into 0.52 divided by 2, yes, 48.67 kilonewton meter. Then the bending moment at B again, if you check, it is 360 into 1.08 into 1.08 divided by 2. So we'll get it as 209.85 kilonewton meter. Okay, so we'll go back and we'll check. Okay, let's just show you the free body diagram here. Okay, if you check here, it is 360. Okay, UDL cantilever, it is like cantilever beam subjected to UDL. So that time the maximum minimum at support only, the maximum minimum will be at support. So it will be how much? We have to consider this beam as a this part, that is A to C, this part as a cantilever beam with respect to the cantilever beam with UDL. So that time the maximum minimum will be at support. This column A we have to consider as a support. So that time the basic equation, that is for cantilever beam with UDL, that is W L square by 2. So W is 360 here now. 360 into 0.52 is length. So W into L square by 2, or W into L into L by 2. Or then here also, if you consider it is 360 into 1.08 into 1.08 divided by 2. So we get it as, so we got the bending moment at A and bending moment at B, both the values. Okay, then after that, again the bending moment at D is equal to 0. Bending moment at D is equal to 0. Okay, so we will draw the shear force and bending moment diagram with respect to this. Okay, this calculation. Okay, I will draw the bending moment and shear force diagram. Okay, just I'll have this. First of all, the shear force diagram. So we have, so we got it as the shear force at left of A. So I'll just name it here A, B, C, D. So okay, this is A, B, C and D. A, B, C, D. Okay. So therefore, the shear force at left of A and right of A, we got it as here. So I'll just draw. So here we got it as 187 plus 187, it is upward, minus 562, so we'll get it as downward. It is downward. Then here also we'll get it as positive and negative. So 661 positive and 338 negative. Okay. So this we have to note it down. So we got this as 187.20. This has 562.8. Okay. Understood? 187.2, 562.8. And this we got it as 661.20. And this we got it as 388.80. So I'll just join here. Okay, so here I have to join. So this is positive upward. Then I have to join this both. Then also I have to join this. Okay. This is with respect to A, B, C, D, because we already have shear force as C and D, both are 0. Okay. Now we'll draw the shear force, bending moment diagram. This is SFD. I'll write just right here. SFD. Okay. Then we'll draw the bending moment diagram. Again, same. We'll draw it here. Draw the bending moment diagram here. So the same. Yes. So we'll note it as, this is as A, B, C and T. A, B, C, D. Okay. So after that, okay, I'll just draw with the rough. First of all, with the, just check.
So we got this as like this, hogging, then again sagging. Just okay, I'll draw it now. I just tried with pencil. Okay, so this we got, then I got this as hogging. Okay, yes, it's getting perfect space. Okay, yes, correct. Okay, so I'll just hold on the balance now. So here we got it as this, we got it as 48.67. Okay, and this we got it as, I have made a mistake here. This should be A here. Okay, this should not be A, this should be A here. Here A, this should be B. Sorry, at B we got it as this. This is, got to make a correction here. AB, okay, at A is 48.67 and at B is, the measurement is 209.85. 209.85. At A, we got the measurement at A as, that is 48.67, and at B as 209.85. So this I can write positive, positive, negative. Here also shear force, positive, negative, positive, negative. So this is Bending diagram, BMD. Okay, understood? Okay, so we got the shear force diagram and Bending diagram. Okay, so next here you have to find out where is the location of maximum bending moment. Okay, the location of maximum bending moment or the location of point of contraflexure. Sorry, we have to find out the location of point of contraflexure. Both are same. Where the location of point of flexure will be, where shear force changes its sign from positive to negative, where the shear force will be zero, and there we will get the location of maximum bending moment. Means you have to find out the location of point of contraflexure. So this is nothing but you have to find out this distance. This distance you have to find out. This is as x bar. X bar. Okay, x bar. So for by any method you can find out this. If you have any method you can find out this. I have used here the concept of symmetrical triangle. So here I'll assume this as distance x. This will be x. The remaining distance, this will be from here to here, it is 3.4 minus x. This will be 3.4 minus x. If this is x, this is 3.4 minus x. Okay, understood. So therefore I can use the similar triangle method here. So that is x by 562.8 is equal to 3.4 minus x divided by 661.8. okay, what is, I can see here. So this divided by this, so that is x divided by 562.8 is equal to 3.4 minus x divided by 661.20. So this is 20. Okay, so this is 20. Okay. Understood? X, so this is this divided by this is equal to this divided by this, similar triangle. Okay, so that is x by this, or is equal to 3.4 minus x divided by 661.20. so from this we'll get it as x is equal to 1.56 meter. So we got this as 1.52. so therefore x bar is equal to 1.56 plus this distance. So that is 0.52. So we'll get it as x bar, we'll get it as 2.08 meter. We'll get it as x bar is equal to 2.08 meter, because this distance is 0.52 and x is 1.56. So the distance x bar from C, the distance x bar, the location of point of contraflexure from C is 2.08 meter. So you have to practice this. And if you have any queries, we can discuss that in the next session. We are going to discuss in the next session, that is in Google Meet. Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much.